What's happening, YouTube? Cowboy here, and today I'm going to show you how to respec in Lords of the Fallen. So I wasn't sure if it was possible, but after a little bit of exploring, I finally figured it out. So first thing we have to do is go grab a key. Now, of course, this is the same room where you fight the first warden, and after we get past him and leave that room, I'm gonna go on down, and once we get down a little bit. You may remember that early on in the game, there's an item right over here that you need to jump. You need to get it. Now this, it's like Northern Monastery Wing Key, I believe is the full name of it. And we weren't able to figure out where it goes before. So grab that key. Now once you grab that key, the entrance to where you're going to get your respec is slightly hidden. And it's going to take a little bit of finagling to get in there. But a little bit of luck, you should be able to jump straight in and you'll be fine, and I made a wrong turn. So, go down there, get the key, obviously right after the first boss. This is very early in the game. And of course, we're going to go right back across the boss room here. Over to here. Now you'll notice this rock is kind of broken down. You can climb up here. You might notice this kind of raggedy curtain hanging there. So what we're going to do is walk up onto the ledge, then get a little bit of a running start, and then jump. Now, we kind of fat rolled off there, unfortunately, but with a slightly better aim, should be fine, and we should jump right in. So, once again, we will go. There we go, and a nice jump in. So once you get in here, just follow it around. There's a couple other pieces of loot you will find in this area. A little bit of a gap here, so a running jump doesn't hurt. But right here is where you will use your key, and then right here is where you will find your Shard of Heroes. Now, once you get your Shard of Heroes, as you can see right here, whatever this object is, it can be used in multiple ways. One of them is bound to an old legend that the reason why three hero statues were erected within Keystone was not an act of tribute, but a decoy aimed towards hiding something very valuable. The other use is obvious. So, there are two uses, in fact, for this. One of them being that you can use it to respec. Now, if you remember this, there's three big statues right in the middle of the courtyard that they're talking about here, right where you fought the Guardian boss, which is the second boss in the game. So that's a spoiler for you. My apologies, but it's pretty damn early. But either way, just walk up to whichever statue you want to respec your class to with the Shard of Heroes, the statue with the dagger if you want to be a rogue, the one with the sword if you want to be a warrior, or the one with a hammer if you want to be a cleric. And then it will reset all of your attributes and all of your spell points, in addition to giving you the starting spell tree of the selected hero. Now, the other usage is not entirely clear to me. To my knowledge, somebody was mentioning that if you don't respec, you can use this to cause the beast to smash the statues, which I know is part of an achievement or trophy if you're a PlayStation person. But I haven't had a chance to test that out, so that's going to be one of the things I'll look into next playthrough. But either way, at least we have confirmation that you can indeed respec in Lords of the Fallen, which means I could turn this super ultra beefy badass warrior into a super deadly rogue if I wanted to, but more than likely I'll just optimize the stats and do a follow-up build video. But either way, guys, thanks for tuning in real quick. After I found this, I just wanted to bring a quick video to you guys, because up until now, my knowledge was that I was going to have to, you know, play through as rogue and play through as cleric to try those weapons, simply because once you get to higher levels, as you can see, the XP investment per attribute point is pretty damn high at 125,000 experience per attribute point. But either way, thanks for tuning in, guys, and make sure to stay tuned for more Lords of the Fallen content, and we will see you next time.